We get asked so many times, how can I extend my wireless down to my gate? How can I extend it to my granny flat? How can I extend it to my shed or down to my paddock? My access point in my building isn't strong enough. What can I get? Can I get a booster? How can I make it actually happen? Well, I thought it'd be worthwhile re-recording and updating one of these videos that I've already done. So in this edition, what do I need to run? We're going to be talking about point to point. So what do I need to run point to point? So I guess the first place would be to start, why do I need a point to point network? Well, this is probably one of the reasons we get asked this question so many times. I have an intercom that's wireless that I'd like to put on my gate. It's 40 meters from my house. I'd like to get the wireless into my shed. I'd like to extend the wireless to my granny flat. I have a solar array at the end of my paddock. I would like to get internet connection there because the device needs to talk to the internet to be able to be controlled. Our belief at this stage is that we need a powerful access point, a single one that we can maybe keep in our main property, and all of our other equipment will connect to it. The problem we have that is that wireless is about density, not distance. It's about having devices close enough to an access point to get the correct speed. Here's a really simple analogy. You and a child take a soccer ball. You, being an adult, kick the soccer ball as hard as you can and ask the child to run after it. Once the child run after it, you ask them to stop where they are and kick it back to you. The likelihood is they won't be able to kick it all the way back to you. And this is the same with wireless. We could put a really strong wireless access point like that adult in our property, in our main property. It can shout the loudest. It can kick the ball the furthest. But the problem is that the device connecting into it, our smart light bulb, our smart doorbell, our wireless camera is like that child. It can't shout very loudly. And as a result, the signal will never get all the way back to us. So this is about getting connectivity as close as we can to the device that needs it, not about trying to get the most powerful device that we can in one property. So that's a reason really why we need a point-to-point wireless to be able to extend wireless over a large distance. So I guess that leads us to the next question. What is point-to-point wireless? Well, point-to-point wireless, put simply, is really an Ethernet cable made up over the air. It would be the same as you running an Ethernet cable in the ground. Now, with a point-to-point connection, the further you go apart between the two devices that create the point-to-point, the slower the speed will be. That doesn't mean that it will be super slow. It depends on what you need to achieve to which devices you use. You can have devices that will create a point-to-point connection and provide you over a gigabit a second between each device, the same as you'd get from an Ethernet cable. So point-to-point is the ability to take two devices. For example, we'll talk about them in a minute. These are two nanobeams, Ubiquiti nanobeams. Put these 500 meters apart, a kilometer apart, and they will create a connection between two locations as if an Ethernet cable had been run between them. This creates a reliable way for us to connect devices together. And that's why it's the most reliable way to be able to get connectivity to devices that are probably going to be maybe, let's say, more than 30 to 40 meters away from a normal home grade wireless access point or your router. So the next question is, what do I need to make the point to point work? Well, firstly, you need clear line of sight. What does that mean? If I am to stand in the location of where I'm going to, if you like, mount the transmitter, although these are transmitters and receivers, where I'm going to mount one of these, I need to be able to clearly see the place where I'm going to mount the receiving end of this. There can't be anything in the way. There can't be a building, a hill. There can't be lots of trees. Might be able to be some foliage, but wireless is not like traveling through metal. It does not like traveling through wood. I know it might sound strange to say there can't be anything in the way, but many customers say, oh, what is line of sight? We can see line of sight, but there's this huge factory in the way. All of those things are going to stop this point-to-point working. So if you can get above it by mounting a pole on your roof or extending the height of where you can put it so you can see above it, then that will get around it. Some people say, can it be pointing down here? As long as it's clear line of sight. So in the each building can see the same portion where you're going to actually mount these on either side. It doesn't matter if they're pointing upwards, downwards, sideways. As long as they can see each other, clear line of sight between both of those. That is the most important thing. The next thing you're going to need is a device. The device is going to depend on the speed you want and the distance it's going to be. So we tend to say, for up to say 200 meters, maybe a little bit less, 200 meters, you can probably use one of these. You can use a nano station. I'll just grab one of these out of the box here so you can have a look. Small little device like this. All right, again, it's going to mount on your wall, going to point at the other device. Look, the spectrum of Wi-Fi is probably only like about this. All right, so there isn't much to play with, so it does need to be directional. But if you want to get less than 100 megasecond at probably 100 or 200 meters, this is the perfect device. What happens? We'll talk about how it all fits together in a moment. If you are wanting to get probably up to about 500 meters and you're wanting to get 100, 200 megasecond, then probably something like this nano beam is going to be a good option. Obviously, remember, you're going to need two of them, one at either end. Then above that, we go up to the power beam. The power beam is probably going to help us at 1 or 2 kilometers. If you're only needing maybe 5 or 10 megasecond, then you could probably start to push that out to 10 kilometers. We've got the gigabeam and the gigabeam plus. These at 500 meters or more should be able to give you over a gigabit a second. So you need to choose the device for the speed and the performance that you're going to be. You're going to need to mount it on something. So it can mount on the wall, it can mount on a bar. Most people have these on like scaffold poles, or you can buy wall mounts and things from us that gives you options to mount them on the roof or the wall. The main thing is that clear line of sight and then choosing two of these. Like I said, you'll need one for either end. Then you'll need a way of powering it. These are PoE powered. They use 24 volts. Obviously at your primary end, that's probably not a problem. If you're going to be at your gate end, maybe you haven't got power down there. Then you need to think about how do you get power there. You might need to have a solar panel. You may be like going to use something like the solar switch by Ubiquiti that allows you to have a panel in one side and your batteries in the other and power your devices off this. That's one way of getting power to your devices. But you will need to think about the power for both ends. Obviously, if it's two buildings you're joining together, then that's not a problem. You could have a PoE switch at either end, or a PoE injector at either end. If you're not sure what PoE is, I've got a great video on what do I need to run power over Ethernet, and it talks to you all about those type of things. And these devices use 24 volt PoE. That's for most of the Air Max products. So there you go. You need clear line of sight. You need the right device. All right. Then you need some power at either end. All right, and then you need to decide how many devices are going to be connected together. If there's several devices, maybe you've got a camera and an access point, and you're going to be connecting it also to your point-to-point device, then maybe you need a small switch. This is the nano switch. It can be mounted on a pole like this. It's PoE powered, and probably can't get the bottom off this very easily. Here we go. And it's got 4 ports in the bottom. So one of those is going to be your power and internet in. So that might be from your nano station. And then it's going to give you connections out to your other devices. So you will need to choose your power and then how many or what devices is going to be connected at the other end. We've obviously now already talked about what do I need to create a point-to-point network. So we've talked about the devices, how to power them, clear line of sight. There are instructions on our YouTube channel. There's a video there on how to configure the operating system in these to create your point-to-point. So now we've created our point-to-point. We've basically extended our connectivity from our main property out to a remote location. So let's now just think about what are we going to do at that other end? What is the function? Maybe it's just for a camera. That's great. It's maybe going to connect to a nano switch or a flex switch or something like that. And what we've created is just like an Ethernet cable. It sits there seamlessly. If you've got a DHCP server or your router in your main property, everything that that gives out, the IPs and everything, is now available at your remote location. So you can wire using Ethernet cable into the bottom of your device like this, or into your nano beam, for example. You can plug directly through the PoE injector, your camera or your smart intercom system or whatever it is. Now, in some instances, you need to provide wireless at that remote location. So you now need to think about, you're going to come out of your nano station, all right, or your nano beam in this instance. It's going to come down to your power over Ethernet injector or maybe a PoE switch. All right, and then it needs to connect on to another access point. So maybe you're doing this from a granny flat. And so you've done your point-to-point connection, you've done two nano beams. This has got your connectivity there. This is on the outside of the wall. Through comes the Ethernet cable through the wall. And then on the other side, that's where you've got your power connected for your power over Ethernet. And then maybe you're going to loop it through to something like this, the Unify AC Pro. And that AC Pro is going to be mounted on the ceiling. And this is the device that all of your other devices, your phones, laptops, smart TVs are going to connect to. And this is going to give you actual Wi-Fi in that location. This is going to create your point-to-point, your nanostation or nanobeam. This is going to create your consumer device Wi-Fi. Maybe your gate, then maybe you have to use something like the Ubiquiti AC mesh, which is an outside access point. And then your intercom system or your smart doorbell or whatever it is can connect to it. So you need to think about what I'm going to do. See, if you've got a wooden shed, maybe you can just put the access point and AC mesh on the outside of it. If it's a metal shed, you again need to be able to get connectivity or wireless inside because the metal is not going to travel inside. So in all of these instances, you're going to need to terminate the connection here. This is your point-to-point distance. Then you're going to cable out from there and you're going to cable into a switch or an injector. And then you're going to cable from that injector into another injector, or if you're doing it with the switch, just with the switch, and then onto your access point. And that then gives you your connectivity in that remote location. If you're doing it outside, use the AC mesh or the AC mesh pro, because that gives you Wi-Fi outside. Still gonna terminate it from the end of your nano beam or nano station, and then connect it, and that will give you then external wireless. So that's what you can do once you get to that end. Maybe you're just going to plug a camera in. So you've got this, and we're going to wire out of this into whatever your camera setup is. And that camera will now be able to see all of the IP addressing and everything that's going on in your main property. And you will have created a big Ethernet cable over the air for the distance you need to go. So then here are some curved balls. All right, many other questions that we get, they'll hopefully help your mind think through what options you've got. Say we have three buildings that we want to connect together. We've got a central one here, we've got one over here and one over here, but they can both see that central building and they're within about 110 degrees of each other if I was to stand at that main building. As long as it meets that criteria that I've got clear line of sight to both ways, then maybe we could use something like this. This is the Ubiquiti LAP120. This is a 120 degree access point. This would go on your main property, and then you'd use a nano station or a nano beam to connect to it from the first property and another one from the other property. And that way you could create a point to multi-point setup where you just have one on the main property. Then another question would be, maybe I've got a property in the middle and I've got one property on this side and one property on that side. The easiest way to do that is to create two point-to-point links. So on our central building, we're going to have essentially two of these back-to-back. They're going to need a switch in the middle, something like the nano switch to join them together, and that's going to come down to your router. And then on the other building at that end, you're going to have one of these, and your other building on the other end, you're going to have one of those. All right, as long as they're all wired together and you've got one pair here and one pair here, all right, then again, you've been able to get connectivity to both of those buildings. That's probably the cheapest and most cost-effective way of actually doing that. So those are two of the curved balls that we often get asked, and there are multiple ways of doing that. If you've maybe got 10 buildings and they're smattered around a central one, then we can take something called a rocket prism. That rocket prism can have an omni antenna on it, or we can put multiple rocket prisms together with 120 degree access points, Air Max products, and then we can have multiple nano stations or nano beams connecting to it. Your other option is to take three of these and mount them in a triangle on a central pole, and then again, you could have multiple devices connecting to it. Just remember that when we start to move into this area, the whole wireless is about density, not distance thing starts to come into play. whichever, in a scenario where we had three buildings, this on the center one and one here and one here, whichever building has the slowest speed will be the speed that all of the buildings run at. So do just remember that it's a restriction that we have with inside our current Wi-Fi standards. So hopefully that's been useful. We've covered why do I need point-to-point. We've covered what is point-to-point. We've covered what do I need for point-to-point. I've covered what do I do when I've got the connectivity at my remote location. And then we've covered a few curveball questions that we often get asked. Hopefully those helped you form some ideas of what you actually might be able to do with this equipment. But do reach out to us either in the comments here or on our website. And we can help you further design what you need. But do go on over to our YouTube channel. We've got loads more box openings on firewalls, networking, and wireless. We've got how-to guides on creating point-to-point connections. Find out what you need to run PoE or power over Ethernet. Learn all of those bits and pieces. So do subscribe and stay up to date. But hopefully this video on what do I need to run point-to-point has been useful.